Hey guys, Josh from SoccerReviewsForYou.com, bringing you an unboxing plus on-feet video of the Acuna Colibri. A lot of you guys have asked to see more variety on the channel as far as products go, so here it is. Now as you can see, they come in a box, which is nothing that is too unusual. Open the box and you will of course find the shoes themselves. So give me a second to get these out of here and we will take a closer look at what is most likely a pair of shoes as well as a brand that you have never heard of before. So here is a look at the Acuna Colibri. The official name of the brand is Acuna Cincastel. You can see the Cincastel branding right there on the tongue itself, embroidered in a very high quality gold stitching. Also on the tongue, you will find an Italian flag as well as the year 1911. Now, as far as this particular product goes, I'm sure a lot of you guys are thinking, these look like a pair of Pantofolodoros, maybe a little bit different, but definitely along the same lines. And I can't really argue against that. It definitely is a very similarly styled kind of old school type of soccer shoe. Now, the story behind this particular brand is that they have been established as a brand and a company since 1997, so they're technically not that old. The reason why you see the 1911 branding on there is because the roots of the company, the generations of shoemakers that have been involved with these designs that Acuna now makes, have been around and date all the way back to 1911. So while the brand itself is only has only been in existence since 1997, the roots of the company have been around for a very, very long time under various names and various shoemakers. So there is a pretty extensive history with this particular brand. If you want to learn more about it, you can check out their website. They have a full, very, very long story about the company. I don't really want to get too much into it. But if that is something that interests you, again, go ahead and check out their website. You can find all of that info there. Now, as far as this product itself goes, I want you guys to leave a comment down below. Let me know if this is something that interests you at all. If this is something that you'd like to see more of on my channel, would you wear these? Would you not wear these? Why or why not? And if you enjoy this type of video and want to see more variety on the channel, be sure to support this video with a like. Now, as far as this particular shoe goes, one of the major qualities is, of course, that it's made 100% out of very, very high quality calf leather material. And from what you can see, it's not perfect. It's not mass produced. And that's one of the major perks of the Acuna brand as a whole. None of their products are mass produced. In fact, all of their products are made handmade in Ascoli, Italy, where the company is based, and they're actually all made to order. So you yourself have to actually make an order directly from the company, or a store has to make an order directly from the company for them to even make a pair of shoes. There's no warehouse of these things sitting around anywhere in Italy waiting to be purchased. These are made to order, handmade in Italy, which is very, very cool. And you can definitely kind of feel and see the freshness of the leather, the quality of the stitching. It's not necessarily perfect, but you can tell that it's very, very well made. And in comparison to something like Pantofolodoro, which is something that a brand that a lot of you guys are going to compare this to, there definitely is more of a handmade quality about the Acuna brand in comparison to something like Pantofolodoro. And if you guys are interested in getting a pair of these for yourself, because they are fairly hard to come by, there aren't many places in North America at all that sell these things, I will leave a link down below in the description. They aren't necessarily cheap. They retail for around $220. But if this is your thing, if you're really into old school shoes, if you really want that kind of classic aesthetic to your footwear and just have a really high quality leather boot in general, and don't necessarily mind paying a little bit more to get that handmade in Italy quality, then this is definitely something to consider, especially if you're more of a boot nerd and you really want something that nobody else has. If you want to be truly unique, this boot will do that for you. Now, as far as the colorway goes, you can tell that this is the all black color, which I think looks absolutely amazing. I can't wait to wear these. If you want to see people looking at your feet, try wearing these as opposed to some bright yellow Vapors or bright yellow F50s. These are going to be one of those shoes that nobody out there on the field is going to have. I guarantee it. Now, as far as the upper itself goes, it is a calfskin leather upper, extremely high quality. It's pretty much melting in your hands, and it's just very, very soft. You can see it has a nice smooth finish about it, and the crinkles in the upper, while a lot of you guys may look at that and say that looks kind of cheap, it has this very handmade quality about it, this very handmade aesthetic that once you put it on your feet, you can tell that these are just extremely high quality on a level of their own in comparison to any other brand. out there, period. It's just really, really nice, and it's kind of hard to explain, and hopefully it's going to show up on video as far as how nice the quality on this shoe actually is, but really, that's all I can say is that, trust me when I say that the quality of the leather, the quality of the craftsmanship is above and beyond anything else that I've personally held in my hands. Now, as far as the leather itself goes, I would say that it's about a medium thickness, not too thick, not too thin, and the overall bulk level of the shoe is fairly minimal in comparison to something like a Pantofole Oduro. The tongue itself does have a decent amount of padding to it, I definitely will say that, but it is 100% made from leather, so in terms of having a nice uniform touch across the entire foot, you're definitely going to get that with this particular boot. Now, as far as moving to the back area of the shoe, you can see it is slightly higher cut, as you would expect from a more traditionally styled shoe. You can see you have a little kind of leather pull tab right here, two actual leather pull tabs right here on the back of the heel, which I think look very, very cool. Gives it, again, kind of that old school aesthetic. Central lacing system, kind of a stitched on overlay of leather to make up what is essentially a heel counter. There is actually something internally there, like a hard plastic or something like that, so it doesn't necessarily lack modern innovation completely. It does have that nice hard heel counter, so it's not only going to lock your heel in place really nicely, it's also going to provide some decent protection. The inside heel liner is actually a synthetic leather material, so in comparison to something like a Pantofole Oduro, where it's actually a natural leather, this is not going to absorb water, and it's going to be a lot more durable in the long run, also a lot more lightweight. The insole is kind of glued in there. You could remove it if you wanted to, but I'm not going to. It's that same type of insole you're going to find in something, again, like a Pantofole Oduro, kind of a textured foam material. It does a good job of feeling nice and comfortable against your foot. Again, I'm not going to remove it just because it ends up kind of wrecking the insole a little bit. And then moving on to the sole plate and stud pattern, this is the firm ground stud pattern that they offer. Pretty straightforward. A lot of you guys may say that it looks a little bit cheap, but again, this is kind of the old school way of doing things. It's a relatively thick plastic, but there still is some nice flexibility to it. And of course, you have a fairly traditional conical stud layout. Four studs in the heel, four studs on the lateral side of the forefoot, three on the medial side, and one support stud in the middle with nylon stitching going all the way around. So as far as durability goes, I would expect these to last a pretty long time. They're really well made. The quality of the materials is absolutely fantastic, and I just can't get enough of this aesthetic. This is, to me, a very cool pair of shoes to wear that I'm extremely excited to test out. In terms of weight, the Calibri is much lighter than I was actually anticipating. So I'm going to weigh this pair for you today in real time. Keep in mind that this is a brand new pair in a size 9 US. We're going to throw them on the scale. And you can see that they weigh in at 10.4 ounces, which is not heavy at all. Definitely is a little bit more in comparison to something like an Adipure 11 Pro, a Nike Tiempo Legend 5, even the current Puma King. But in comparison, it's kind of hard to compare those shoes to something like this. The difference in weight is not significant. This is certainly not in a weight range that is going to weigh you down. And if you were interested in something like this, but were worried that they were going to be too heavy, just keep in mind that at 10.4 ounces, this is still a very, very wearable pair of soccer cleats. All right, here is a look at the Calibris on feet. And if I'm being completely honest with you guys, these are some of the most comfortable shoes I've ever put on my feet. I am extremely excited to wear them, and I just really, really love the overall look and feel of these guys. In terms of the leather quality itself, it's extremely soft from right out of the box, and considering that once you start to wear these things and break them in, they're only going to get softer. This is pretty much the closest thing to a leather sock that I've ever put on my foot, and like I said, I just can't wait to wear them and see how they actually feel and perform. Now, in terms of the overall fit, it is a relatively wide-fitting shoe for the most part, and it's going to be suitable for pretty much all foot types. So no matter whether you have wide or narrow-shaped feet, you're going to fit into these no problem. What's also great about this particular shoe is that the sizing is dead on. I'm wearing my usual size 9 US or a European 42, and the sizing is 100% true and absolutely perfect. So if you are looking to order a pair of these for yourself, keep in mind that they run very, very true to size. Alright guys, that's it for my unboxing of the Acuna Calibri. Like I mentioned, I'm extremely excited to test these out. I love wearing this old school style of shoe, and considering the overall quality of the Calibri model and just the Acuna brand in general, handmade in Italy, that's really all you can ask for from a classic pair of soccer shoes. And honestly, these are some of the nicest classic soccer shoes that I've ever held in my hands. So again, if you're interested in a pair, there will be a link in the description where you can actually buy them. They have them in this colorway as well as another model in another colorway. So go ahead and check that out if that does interest you. If you want to check out the review page on my website, you will find some high quality images of this shoe that'll give you a better idea as to how they actually do look in person. And of course, I will follow up with the full written review in about a month's time. Now, if you have any questions regarding this particular shoe, feel free to leave a comment down below. And also, leave a comment down below. Let me know if you'd be interested in seeing more products from the Acuna brand, because they do have quite a few different models. If you enjoyed today's video, be sure to support it with a like. Subscribe if you haven't already for daily videos on all the latest and greatest soccer gear. You can find all of my social media information down below in the description as well. And other than that, guys, hope you enjoyed today's video. And as always, thanks for watching.